Axiata Group says it has placed its 65% owned unit in Thailand, Suvitech Co., under voluntary liquidation. The group said Expand Investments Labuan, a company wholly owned by Axiata via Axiata Business Services, had registered Suvitech's voluntary liquidation on May 1st. In a board's filing today, Axiata said it is repositioning and restructuring ABS to refocus on core products and operating markets. Axiata added that the consolidation of the ABS business and decision to exit the subscale Thailand market led to the voluntary liquidation of Suvitech. Axiata said Suvitech's voluntary liquidation would not have any material financial or operational impact on the group for FY 2023. Suvitech, an information technology solutions and service company, was incorporated in Thailand in May 2002. In May 2017, ABS entered into an agreement for the acquisition of 65% of the issued share capital of Suvitech for $11.05 million. Meanwhile, Axiata also entered into a binding term sheet to combine the operations of its 82.27% owned subsidiary, Dialog Axiata, with Indian telco Bharti Airtel's operations in Sri Lanka, Bharti Airtel Lanka Private. In a joint statement, the three parties said the proposed transaction envisages Airtel being granted a stake in Dialog Axiata, representing the fair value of Airtel Lanka. Discussions of the proposed transaction are ongoing between the three companies and also with the relevant regulatory authorities as per applicable laws and regulations. Bloomberg reported in March, citing sources, that Axiata was exploring a strategic review of its businesses, with total assets of $81.6 billion to streamline its operations and raise funds to pare debts, which included possibly spinning off or selling its assets outside Malaysia. Construction group GDB Holdings unit Grand Dynamic Builders has been issued with a notice of arbitration by KSK Land's wholly owned subsidiary Damai City over the 8 Conlay project termination dispute. According to a Bursa Malaysia filing by GDB on Tuesday, Damai City claimed for costs and expenses incurred for the delayed completion of the project. The claims included loss of profits, reputation and general damages for breach of contract. The arbitration notice was filed in response to GDBS's notice of demand amounting to $102.07 million on April 25th, which has to be paid on or before May 2nd. GDBS was appointed as the main contractor for KSK Land's flagship 8 Conlay mixed development project after GDB secured the letter of intent on October 2020. However, on April 19, 2023, KSK Land terminated GDBS as the main contractor for the project, citing failure to achieve agreeable solutions to various disputes relating to construction site matters over a prior nine-month period. GDBS said in Tuesday's filing that it could take legal action against Damai City under the Construction Industry Payment and Education Act 2012. GDBS could also start arbitration proceedings against Damai City. MIDF Research is keeping its buy call on UMW Holdings and MBM R-esources following Perusahaan Automobil Kedua or Perdua's clarification that the Perdua Axia remains safe for driving. To recap, on Friday, Daihatsu Motor Co. had confirmed that it had committed procedural irregularity on the Japanese firm's site collision impact safety testing for four models, including the new Perdua Axia. The other three models were Toyota Agya, Toyota Yaris Ativ, and an undisclosed upcoming product. Perdua's management explained that despite the revelation by Daihatsu, the UN R95 certification accorded to Perdua Axia remains intact based on its engagement with the relevant safety testing authorities and agencies following the news. As such, MIDF said that no recall will be issued, nor will there be a halt in production of the Axia. A similar statement was issued by UMW on Toyota Vios, highlighting that subsequent testing has validated that the Vios meets the UN R95 certification and there is no need for the model to be recalled, while sales and production will continue without disruption. In its note, MIDF said Perdua's clarification should provide some relief to investors and could present an opportunity to buy. MIDF has a target price of R5.28 on UMW and a target price of R4.70 on MBM R-esources. UMW shares closed 0.78% lower to R3.84 on Tuesday, while MBM R-esources R-esources shed 1.67% or 6 cents to close the day at 3.53 ringgit. Daihatsu Motors' procedural irregularities in regard to the side collision impact safety testing for the four models arose from the addition of a notch to minimize the risk of door panels breaking into sharp edges and causing injuries when the side airbag is deployed, whereby the modification is not present in production vehicles. Twenty-seven investors, including Tat Hin Precision Engineering, have filed a suit seeking almost $10 million against beleaguered Ace Holdings. So far, this is the largest group of plaintiffs suing Ace Holdings. They filed the suit at the High Court through Messrs. Chan Eng & Co. on March 28th this year. The plaintiffs claimed that they had separately entered into a private placement memorandum and share subscription agreement for the issuance of 9.6 million preferential shares to them between June 2017 and December 2020. As part of the agreement, the plaintiffs allege that they will enter a sum for commitment which is fully redeemable after 5 years, with promises of annual returns of 12% to be paid at a rate of 6% on a semi-annual basis. They had invested between 200,000 and 1.15 million ringgit each, according to the statement of claim cited by The Edge. The plaintiffs claim that after reading the offer, they believe they would get the 12% annual return on investment and decided to enter into the agreements with Ace Holdings. They claim that since last year, they had separately tried to redeem their investments, but Ace Holdings had replied that since its operations were badly affected by the COVID-19 pandemic, payments would be delayed. The case was called for case management on Tuesday before High Court Assistant Registrar Anith Farhana Azman, who fixed May 18th for the case to be managed again via e-review. Earlier, Ace Holdings had filed a judicial management petition, which is fixed for hearing on May 17th. Ace Holdings is currently facing action from the Securities Commission for its recent attempt to take over Apex Equity Holdings, as well as suits from several investors over its failure to deliver investment returns. Globetronics Technology saw its first quarter FY 2023 net profit plunge by 65% to 3.3 million from 9.45 million previously. Top line also dropped 23% year-on-year to 33.1 million from the 42.8 million posted in the first quarter of FY 2022. Globetronics attributed its earnings and revenue slump to lower volume loadings or production units from the group's customers, followed by higher tax expense of 1.9 million for the quarter and forex losses. It said the group is expected to experience a decline in profitability for the financial year due to several factors, including softer revenue forecasts from customers, the full impact of increased minimum wages, and increase in utilities cost, among others. On its prospects, the company said it has taken measures and strives to minimize any potential exposures or disruptions arising from the challenges in the semiconductor industry. Globetronics says despite these challenges, it remains committed to finding new and innovative ways to drive growth and profitability.